Honorable members will notice that so far as public relations go, the bill has covered adequate ground for staff. In a manner like the company's bill, however, which covers the entire field of the operation of joint stock companies, the limits of consultation and discussion can never be exhausted. And I would like to inform honorable members that although the bill was introduced in Parliament over 7 months ago, our officers have been engaged throughout this period in further studies and informal discussions with the interests concerned, and on occasions I have also participated in such discussions. First off, I have also given some further thought to some of the issues arising out of the bill, and I propose at the appropriate stage to bring before the select committee any changes in the provisions of the bill which seem to me to be worthy of consideration in the light of this further examination. First up, now honorable members will have noticed that the bill contains 6 clauses and 12 schedules. First up, I think it is probably one of the longest legislative measures in recent legislative history. First off, but its size might be regarded as misleading unless I make a few comments. First off, the bill is both, one must remember, a consolidating and amending measure. First off, as mentioned in the statement of objects and reasons, this is the first opportunity which has occurred since 1923 for the consolidation of the Companies Act. First up, advantage has been taken of this opportunity to redraft several long and complicated sections in the present Act, which have been split up into a large number of clauses. First up, this is the largest single factor accountable for the increase in the number of clauses in the bill. First up, new clauses embodying substantial changes in the present law would hardly constitute more than a small fraction of the bill. First off, I would also draw attention to the structural changes in the bill to which a reference has been made in the statement of objects and reasons. First off,